After six iterations of this franchise, you would think that folks would stop putting their faces close to weird-looking eggs. But I guess they get a pass this time because it's technically a prequel and a sequel. It's Alien Romulus. I'm Ronald Young Jr., and I'm leaving the theater. This is Ronald, and I am leaving the theater after seeing Alien Romulus. Alien Romulus. Written by Fede Alvarez and Rodo Sayeguez. Directed by Fede Alvarez. Starring Kaylee Spani, David Johnson, Eric Hugh Renaud, Isabella Merced, Spike Fearn, and Eileen Wu. All right, Alien Romulus. It is, I want to say, the seventh installment of Alien. It might be the eighth. The seventh or eighth installment of the Alien franchise. For those of you that know anything about it, it started back with Ridley Scott, followed by Aliens, which was James Cameron. The first one is a horror movie. Second one is more of an action adventure. Since then, they've kind of stayed on an action adventure more than horror. I'd say action adventure with horror elements. Essentially, for anyone who's ever known anything about Alien. So the basic premise of the movie is, of all the franchises, is that there's these alien parasites that essentially use human hosts in order to breed what ends up being kind of a homicidal killing alien that also has acidic blood. Each one of these movies features a group of people that are all encountering the said alien and trying to run away from them or engage with them, fight them in some sort of form. This movie is no different. It is a bunch of people, a bunch of kids of miners that work for what's called the Wayland Corporation. They are trying to escape their fate as being kind of corporate. They're kind of enslaved to the corporate machine in a very specific way, where they have them kind of running on a hamster wheel, not literally or even existentially, but like kind of, well, more existentially than literally. But the point is, they're running on this little hamster wheel, and the whole idea is that they want them to keep working there, and the only way they could break out of the cycle is by leaving this place. They dream to leave this mining colony and go to this other island where there's sunshine, because there's none on the place that they're going. I liked this movie. Now, here's the thing. I like most of the Alien movies. I even like the new ones. I like Prometheus. I didn't care too much for Alien Covenant because I feel like I was promised something that did not actually happen. After watching Prometheus, I did not get what I wanted in Alien Covenant. I feel like they walked themselves back from some of the promises that they made in the movie and then kind of made something different, which wasn't really as enjoyable. But this one was pretty good. I think they kind of returned to the roots. It is meant to be kind of what is called an interquel, which is a movie between Alien and Aliens, which tells another kind of self-contained story, which... And I think the reason why they do that is so that it doesn't end with necessarily a fixed point. So we can kind of watch it and kind of just see what happens in this movie and it not necessarily impact the events that happen in Alien or Aliens. That being said, this probably, the way it ended, could probably spin off into its own little branch of the Alien cinematic universe. But it's pretty good. I enjoyed it. I feel like... It is billed as a horror movie. in a lot of ways. In the trailers, there's a lot of tense moments, there's a lot of jump scares, and that stuff is in the movie, but it's not the whole movie. The movie runs about an hour and 59 minutes, and it has the similar beats to most Alien films, meaning that there's some sort of objective, that objective goes horribly wrong, somebody gets infected with a parasite, next thing you know, the aliens pop out, and then for the final hour of the movie, we're trying to survive, because there's also like a time limit in which an objective has to be reached. We have to escape by this time or the whole ship's going to explode, but also we're running from this monster that's tearing apart the ship, which is a very basic plot, but it's done well. The tension is very good here, and there's always a synthetic human or an android, in these films. This one is played by David Johnson, who I was introduced to in Industry, in one of my favorite shows. And boy, is he valuable to this film. As far as I'm concerned, he is the reason why I enjoyed this movie so much. He draws you in. His acting is very good. You are very concerned with his fate. I will say one of the biggest problems of this movie is that there is an unintentional slave metaphor that happens that I think if black people would have written this movie, they might have leaned into or actually made more commentary on, but I don't believe that the makers of this film were necessarily doing that. And as a result, something happens to Andy, is the name of the android, by the end of the film that I did not really appreciate. Like, I was just like, I wish y'all hadn't done that. I wish you had gone the direction it was already going. Let's say there's a bit of self-actualization that happens that is kind of ripped away, a la Of Mice and Men, Charlie, Flowers for Algernon. There's a part where you're rooting for Charlie in Flowers for Algernon, and there's a part where you stop, where you're just like, oh, nah, Charlie's gonna revert. That's kind of how I feel about this movie and Andy being in it. I would definitely like to say more about that, but I don't want to spoil the movie for anybody. But I'm just saying, like, he's really enjoyable in it, enough so that I'm like kind of looking at his career and wondering what will he do after this, as a result of this, because this is kind of like a big move for him. He's done other films. He's had something popular. There was a romance movie that came out that I'm completely forgetting the name of, but he did that last year or the year before, which was really popular. Somebody's screaming it right now. But anyway, David Johnson, great actor. Kaylee Spaney is fine. Everybody else in this movie is basically fine. Everyone's doing exactly what they're supposed to do, but I really feel like this is kind of a star vehicle for David Johnson, and I really hope that he gets, you know, some much bigger roles as a result of this, because I think Industry is a great show. I think there's great acting happening on that show, and he was one of the bright stars of that show, so it was good to see him in this. So, far from the unintentional kind of slave metaphor that I think would have been served better leading into it, another thing that I hate about this movie was that it is mixed poorly and everyone has an accent. Everyone has some sort of like British accent. That paired with the poor mixing made it difficult to really understand what was being said at times. Like, and nothing's wrong with accents, people speak all kinds of ways, but there was a lot of ways in which I felt like my ears were kind of squinting at the screen and being like, what was that? And they were mixing it in a way that made it sound very authentic, so you want it to be echoey when it's supposed to be echoey, and there's machinery and stuff going in the background, so sometimes I feel like whoever mixed it was like, yeah, that's fine, and it was not indeed fine, which kind of like took me out of it. So I kind of had to like watch and kind of guess some of the things that were happening. Not necessarily guess, but there were some parts of it where I just kind of had to like figure out, based on what was happening in the plot, what they just said or what they were about to say, which was a little bit frustrating. Other than that, solid movie. I mean, like I said, tension was good. I was on the edge of my seat. I bought a whole seat. I only needed the edge. Wasted a lot of money there. Actually, I didn't buy it. This is a press screening. I'll let your boy. But no, it was good. I enjoyed it. I think if you like Alien, you will like this movie. I really liked Prometheus. This is probably, after Prometheus, my favorite post-original Alien movie. Just really enjoyed it. It was a good movie. I'm glad I went to the theater to see it. I would have enjoyed it on the couch. I would have enjoyed it there. I enjoyed it in the theater. So yeah, I mean, with all that being said, I give it a solid 4 of 5 stars. Not perfect. I just said that unintentional slave metaphor, not my favorite. And also the sound was mixed poorly, not my favorite. But I mean, if you give me another movie with David Johnson in it, I feel like we're doing a really good job here. Really enjoyed it. 4 of 5 stars. And with that, Leaving the Theater is a production of Owitz Big Ron Studios. I mixed this episode, and I am mixing all of these episodes. I am doing all of this by myself. I'm scheduling the movies. I am planning for guests. I am driving to the theater. I am figuring out a schedule that works so y'all have a movie every week. When you miss weeks, it's because I didn't have time to see a movie or something wasn't planned. But when you hear it coming every week, it just means that I'm locked and loaded and things are going well. I am able to do that because y'all are helping me out via Patreon. This is a labor of love and it is a tough job. But if you like the show, help us out with the Patreon. You can give as little as $7 a month and it's a big help to us. Y'all heard me say in the Borderlands episode some of the things that we want to do starting in the Patreon. We want to bring back On the Couch as a Patreon only offering. We want to introduce an ad-free feed. We want to do episodes with my dad and my sister that will be exclusive to Patreon. We want to do trailer reaction videos. So it's a lot more work to do that. But if you're contributing to the Patreon, it makes it worthwhile for me to be able to do that extra labor for the show. I'm already doing a lot right now, but I can do more. And I can do more with your help. If you want to help me out, go to patreon.com/leavingthetheater or go to the link in our show notes. Show art from Heather Wilder. Theme music by the mysterious Breakmaster Cylinder. For more information about Alien Romulus, check out our show notes. You can follow me on Twitter, Instagram, TikTok, or Threads at OhitsBigRon. That's at OhitsBigRon. You can find out more about this show and other OhitsBigRon Studio shows by following us on Instagram at OhitsBigRon Studios and on Twitter at OhitsBigRon Stu. That's STEW. Leaving the Theater. We'll be back soon. Thanks for listening. All right, this is Ronald, and I am leaving the theater after seeing Alien Romulus. Alien. Great. I picked the worst spot to record. Alien. All right, I hate it here.